We continue our regular look at the campaign as it plays out in social media and on the web.
20% of respondents said they checked their mobile device every 10 minutes, and 84% said they couldn't go a single day without their mobile devices. We, of course, have been taking a regular look at how such changes are playing out in the presidential campaign.
How are you using social media?
Voters are playing a really large role in communicating campaign messages.
The tweets don't necessarily translate to votes, right?
There's nothing on the TV, nothing on the radio that means that much to me.
So, who's winning the race on the web and social media?
Back in Obama's 2008 presidential campaign is when he really started to utilize the growing social media. There was no question back then that this young political figure was leading the internet race. There were certain strategies that he used 4 years ago, and having won, it is clear that he has a head start in this social media campaign.
I light a cigarette cause I can't get no sleep. There's nothing on the TV, nothing on the radio that means that much to me.
According to Social Media Today, Obama in his 2008 campaign used social media in five specific ways. The first was to make known his political platform. He was certainly not a well-known candidate, and social media helped him to communicate who he was quickly and widely.
Trouble in America.
He created a website, which was the center of his social media work. He had a presence on multiple social networking sites. Lastly, his use of social media encouraged participation from potential voters. He reached out to the public and wanted to involve them in his message that was change.
Give you my confidence, all my faith in life. Don't stand me up, don't let me down. No, I need you tonight.
4 years later, the question is, how is social media affecting today's election?
Mr. Chairman and delegates,
Madam Chairwoman, delegates,
I accept your nomination for President of the United States.
I accept your nomination for President of the United States.
While Obama still leads in frequency of social media use for his campaign, unlike last election, his Republican opponent is catching up. Both Obama and Mitt Romney are opening themselves up to communicating with a wide range of potential voters, but are also opening themselves up to the dangers of such transparency.
The shape I'm in.
Their campaigns are constantly commented on, and it's easy to try to appeal to the internet majority rather than sticking to one's political ideals. There is definitely something to be said about the threat of over-democratization in such an internet age. Can constant feedback from the people be a detriment to political progress? Whatever the consequences of this social media revolution, there is no stopping it. The feedback will keep coming and the benefits are numerous. Analysts of social media have the ability to pull a general political sentiment from users. Wide opinions on big issues can be constantly shared.
I got the movie script, but I don't know what it meant.
And communication has never been faster. Whatever the outcome of the 2012 presidential election, the conversation on the effects of constant communication will continue. After November, there will certainly be more information on just how social media affects politics.
All my life, watching America.